Hello friends. In my entire career of instrumentation engineering, I have never ever seen a magic sensor like capacitive proximity sensor. It has really helped me a lot, particularly when I found myself in a great trouble of not having spares. Yes, this is capacitive proximity sensor, a magic. You just name the application. It can work as a level switch, it can work as a flow switch, it can work as a position switch or proximity switch, which is its main function. You can also explore many more applications with this capacitive proximity sensor in your plant. Its principle of operation is very much similar to inductive proximity sensor. But here, sensing method is capacitive kind rather than inductive one. Inductive proximity only senses metal objects. But capacitive proximity, you just name the material. It can sense any material which has some dielectric constant higher than air or gas. Watch on the screen. It has two electrodes as any other capacitor has, separated by a fixed distance. So when a material having some dielectric constant comes in close proximity to these electrodes, its capacitance changes. Now this capacitor is a part of oscillator circuit placed inside this body. It causes a change in frequency of this oscillator due to change in capacitance, which further drives a schematic trigger circuit and finally a relay driver circuit or transistor NPN or PNP switch. The threshold of capacitance change due to material sense you can set with a potentiometer located behind its sensor. So this potentiometer helps you calibrate the sensor. I tell you how. Now as I said, the medium it can sense is almost anything other than gas or air. It may be wood, plastic, liquid, water, oil, grease, which has some dielectric constant, different from air. Got it? The material you want to sense, you need to bring it in your laboratory, or you can carry out this calibration process at site, no issue. Fill this material in a small container and carry out all the electrical connection with the sensor and load circuit. Now first check the sensor when it senses air. Its status should be off. If the sensor is of normally open type, it should be on if it is normally closed. Now dip the sensor in material or liquid. It must change its state from off to on. If it's already well calibrated, if not, tune the potentiometer located behind its back until it changes state from off to on. Now bring back this sensor in air and it must be off. Your sensor is now calibrated. Now you can deploy this sensor wherever you want. The moment material or liquid level goes up or down, it detects a dielectric constant change. Hence, this sensor triggers state from off to on or on to off depending upon the type of sensor, whether it is NO or NC type. Now I tell you where I have used this sensor successfully. I have used this to sense the ink level in a plastic tank by mounting this sensor outside the tank to sense the ink level. First I calibrated with empty tank to sense only plastic body. And finally with filled tank with ink, it worked fine. You may be having various kinds of dedicated design level switches in your plant like impeller type, admittance type, vibrating flow, float level and many more, which uses some electronics or mechanical means to sense the level and trigger a relay or switch. You can replace all the proximity switches with capacitive proximity switches sensor, but make sure compatibility of material to sense with material, as it will come in direct contact with sensing media, so it may react with the sensor. If the material or liquid is toxic in nature, you can place a wall of appropriate material and sense the change in height. I have also used in a grease tank to sense the low level. The same calibration I have followed with empty and filled tank and adjusting the calibration potentiometer. This sensor can be fitted outside hydraulic tank glass oil level indicator to detect oil level in case you don't have a dedicated spare level switch, or in emergency cases you can use to detect the oil level. I have also used this sensor to sense the high and low level of powder granule material by mounting this sensor in a pipe and dipping this pipe in directly the material. Make sure the material should not be chemically react with sensor tip and temperature must be within specified limit of sensor. If you need high temperature sensor, you must contact your OEM for high temperature ranges. It can reliably sense presence of water. So accordingly, you can use it in water tank or liquid tank. You can also sense flow in open channels or in a pipe. This can be mounted outside the pipe or to sense the level in an open channel. But you need to ensure installation must be such that it detects absence and presence of liquid in case of zero flow. There are endless numerous applications which can be accomplished by capacitive proximity switches. I can tell you one more thing. You should replace all your inductive proximity switches with capacitive proximity switches to make inventory common, so you can use inventory more effectively. Friends, if you have any queries or doubts, post them in the comment section. Sure, we will discuss. Keep watching, keep sharing this channel. Bye-bye. Thank you.